Clinical trials are important because they're the best way we have to determine whether or not our experimental treatments are safe and effective and can be used as medications to help patients. Clinical trials can be designed in a number of different ways, depending on the scientific question that we want to answer. The most common type of clinical trial design is a blinded controlled study. And blinded refers to the fact that neither the patient, nor the investigator, nor the team of scientists working in the company know whether or not the patient is receiving active study drug or a placebo control. There are generally three phases of clinical trial development. In phase one, we determine whether or not the drug is safe in humans. In phase two, we determine the dose and dosing regimen, or how much to give and how often. In phase three, we determine the safety and efficacy. Drugs that are shown to be safe and effective in phase three are then submitted for approval to become treatments for patients. We know a clinical trial has been successful if the study medication causes an improvement in the study endpoint large enough so that we know that it hasn't occurred by chance. If the trial is successful, we do four things. First of all, we submit it for approval of the drug with health authorities. Whether or not it's positive, we will publish the data in scientific journals and also post the data at clinicaltrials.gov and UDRA-CT. If the endpoints of a clinical trial are not met, it can mean a number of things. It can mean that the study was not designed properly, but often it means that this study drug is truly not effective for the treatment of the disease. Novartis tries to include the patient voice at multiple points in the clinical trial process. Before the trial begins, we speak with patient advocacy groups to get a better understanding of the patient's perspective of the disease. Before designing protocols, we'll often speak to patient focus groups. And at the end of the study, we'll write thank you notes to the patients who have enrolled in the study and also let them understand the results of the study. There are three critical groups that determine who should participate in the trials. The first, of course, is the patient, and it's up to them to decide if they have the time or the interest in participating in a trial. The next is the investigator or a physician, and they look at the study protocol and determine whether or not a patient meets the criteria for participation. And finally, the sponsor or the pharmaceutical company writes the protocol to determine which sorts of patients should be included in the trials. There are a number of things to consider when thinking about clinical trial participation. The first is what you want to get out of a trial. Are you interested in learning more about the disease or about potential options for treatment? The second are the logistics. Often participating in a clinical trial means you have to go to a study site and spend a significant amount of time there. And finally, and what I think is the most important, is to consider the altruistic aspects. By participating in a clinical trial, you help patients like yourself, you help potentially future generations, and you help move the science ahead.